Well, Africa being credited with another contribution to science. CNN's Patricia Kelly talked with researchers who have evidence that 20,000 years ago, before the pharaohs of Egypt, another African civilization produced a sophisticated calculator.
Proof that primitive man was well acquainted with mathematics lies under lock and key in the dusty archives on the 19th floor of Belgium's Royal Institute of Natural Science. Best described as a prehistoric calculator, it's a piece of animal bone, just 10 centimeters long, about 4 inches. Discovered in the 1950s by a leading Belgian archaeologist, the bone was found near Lake Edward at Ishango, on the border between the Congo and Rwanda. What sets the bone apart from the other fossils and fragments found at Ishango are its markings, groups of notches arranged in 3 distinct columns.
They are very, very well organized. They are not made at random. If you can make notches at random just to count how many animals you have killed today or something like that, but it's rather well organized.
When the notches are counted, a series of number sequences emerges. They suggest a number system based on 10, another based on 12, as well as a knowledge of multiplication and of prime numbers. This is a replica of the bone. It's thought this piece of quartz at the tip may have been used for writing or engraving. The Ishango bone may also be proof that a highly advanced civilization existed in Central Africa 15,000 years before the emergence of Egyptian culture. Homo sapiens may therefore have evolved in Central Africa before anywhere else in the world.
We have more and more proofs of mathematical activities in Africa, not written, but on stones, on bones, on strings. So indeed, there are more reasons to think that it's the start of, it's the very first mathematical activity. And to my, in my view, of course, it should not be on the 19th floor. It should be on a golden table at the entrance of the museum.
It's thought Ishango man's numbers system may have spread north following the River Nile into Egypt, as well as into West Africa. Now his influence may travel even further. This award-winning film director wants to take the bone into space and make a documentary about it.
I want to make a link between the history, the history of Africa and the future of the mankind.
With the help of the European Space Agency, he's already taken the bone on a practice parabolic flight in zero gravity. The project is a deliberate allusion to the opening scenes from Stanley Kubrick's classic science fiction film 2001, A Space Odyssey. 50 years after the Ishango bone was found and stuffed away in a drawer, it could be blasted into outer space, turning science fiction into fact. That could happen even before it goes on public display here on Earth. Patricia Kelly, CNN, Brussels.